Violence against police seems to be escalating nationwide with the recent murders of Texas Deputy Darren Goforth and Illinois Police Officer Joe Glinowitz. Now one pastor is preparing a national strategy to combat the issue. It's called Adopt Your Street, Adopt a Cop, and it focuses on faith. The program has already been adopted by the San Francisco Police Department. Can this movement narrow the widening gap between police and their communities? Joining me now is Dr. Ed Silvoso, the founder and president of Harvest Evangelism and the International Transformation Network. Doctor, good of you to join us today. It has been a very tragic week, as you know, for the law enforcement community. For that matter, all communities suffer when police are gunned down. It disrupts our sense of security. What is the mission of Adopt a Cop?
Well, Adopt a Cop, which was adopted by the San Jose Police Department, not the San Francisco Police Department, consists in having every police officer adopted in prayer and every neighborhood adopted in prayer so that we can change the spiritual climate over the whole region.
Thank you for correcting me on that. San Jose, not San Francisco. Will it narrow, however, the widening gap between police and troubled communities like Baltimore, Chicago, Texas, Ferguson? The list goes on.
Absolutely, because right now when you say police is faceless, is nameless, but when you adopt a police officer and when you adopt a block, now there is a name, there is a face there. You are not dealing with the police, you are dealing with the officers that are there. And it will definitely not only narrow the gap, hopefully will eliminate the gap, because one in four, could be as high as one in three, police officers are ethnic people. And there is no neighborhood that is 100% non-white. So can you imagine now when we bring both branches together, things change. We have seen a change in many places, Kelly, and we believe there is hope for America.
So how would this program deal with critics to police officers like Black Lives Matter, for example?
Well, I think when it comes to Black Lives Matter, we need to acknowledge that the pain is all over, but it's more deeply felt in the Black community. Okay, the vast majority of the people that are dying or being killed, regardless of who does the killing, are Blacks. So when we say, well, yes, all lives matter, I agree. But let's begin by building a bridge, by saying, I feel your pain, coming together like brothers and sisters, like in Jacksonville, you know, Bishop Vaughn McLaughlin, an African-American bishop, he has a program, do something. And they patrol neighborhoods, they take care of everybody, whether they are Black or white. So Kelly, there is hope for America. The church is the only entity that has a branch in every neighborhood and a representative in every block. And this is a call to prayer, to bless, to connect, because when you are prayer walking your neighborhood, you become aware of your neighbors.
All right.
You see a fence down and an owner that has arthritis cannot
Dr.
fix it.
Dr. Silvoso,
I
thank you for your passion. I thank you for your strategy. It's a strategy that sounds like it could work. If you've got a church on every corner, if they're out there actively engaging with police and the neighbors, should be great. Dr. Silvoso, thank you. Adopt a Cop.
Thank you.